On the 2nd of March 2001, a year to the day after the death of Stanley Kubrick, his widow Christiane opened his personal archives, according to his last wishes. Among the mountain of documents, Christiane Kubrick found a file bearing the seal of the President of the United States, classified top secret. In it, she read that Henry Kissinger had come to London to prepare a meeting between Stanley Kubrick and President Nixon.
That did take a long time, but everybody was very interested that it could be done at all. Kissinger was the key person, yeah.
Kissinger arranged to meet us at a cocktail party hosted by Secretary of Defense Donald Rumsfeld. The guests included Lawrence Eagleburger, General Alexander Haig, and ex-CIA Director Richard Helms. 30 years ago, all of them were senior advisors to Richard Nixon.
All right, one more drink and then I'm ready.
There you go.
There you go.
And you have a great chance to make a fool of me.
What is going on? What in the world? Hello, Mel. How are you?
I thought this was a serious program.
I don't know. He looks a little slippery to me.
Now, how are we doing this? He's asking, you're asking the question.
Answering.
Well, but then you're going to have to translate them, so I know for sure what I'm being asked.
Mm. I understand French. I don't speak it very well, but I understand it.
Okay.
What's your problem?
No. Don't worry about it. It's okay.
Seriously.
I'll tell you a fascinating story.
Off the record, not on the camera.
Are you running?
Turn the camera off.
The story they told was amazing. In order to be sure of winning the space race, Nixon decided to fake the filming of Armstrong and Aldrin's steps on the moon. They would film on the set of 2001: A Space Odyssey in Kubrick's London studio. The film was only to be used if the Apollo 11 mission failed. 5 White House security agents were selected for the film crew. They swore never to reveal what they had done. And immediately after the filming, they were spirited away to comfortable lives abroad.
It was a great film, wonderfully done.
It was just amazing.
I was blown away.
But suddenly, the president's advisors were worried. What if one of the witnesses to the filming were to talk? Henry Kissinger and General Al Haig hurried to the White House.
So I went into Nixon, I said, Mr. President, we've got a problem.
Nixon signed an executive order, terminate with extreme prejudice. The CIA sent its agents across the globe to eliminate the witnesses.
La CIA est prohibée par la loi américaine de tuer quiconque.
Did people go to the moon or not?